हेलो फ्रेंड्स, इन चैप्टर नंबर 6 लाइफ प्रोसेसेस वी स्टडी न्यूट्रिशन। वी ऑलरेडी स्टडीड अबाउट ऑटोट्रॉपिक न्यूट्रिशन। लेट्स लर्न हेटेरोट्रॉपिक न्यूट्रिशन। हेटेरोट्रॉपिक न्यूट्रिशन इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम ऑटोट्रॉपिक न्यूट्रिशन। इन ऑटोट्रॉपिक न्यूट्रिशन ऑर्गेनिज्म और ग्रीन प्लांट्स कैन टेक एटमोस्फेरिक कैन यूज एटमोस्फेरिक सनलाइट ड्यूरिंग द प्रोसेस ऑफ फोटोसिंथेसिस एंड हेल्प ऑफ क्लोरोफिल दे कैन मेक देन और फूड। बट इन हेटेरोट्रॉपिक ऑर्गेनिजम्स दे कैन नॉट बी यूज क्लोरोफिल, दे कैन नॉट बी टेकन क्लोरोफिल एंड दे कैन नॉट यूज देयर ऑन फूड। दे डिपेंडेड ऑन अदर फॉर देयर फूड न्यूट्रिशन, सो दे आर कॉल्ड हेटेरोट्रॉपिक, डिपेंडेड ऑन अदर। नॉन क्लोरोफिलस ऑर्गेनिजम्स दे कैन नॉट प्रिपेयर देयर ऑन फूड, दे कैन डिपेंड ऑन अदर्स फॉर देयर फूड पर्पसेस। Depending on type and ability of food materials, they can be divided in two stages. The first is stationary. Either the food material is stationary, like grass eaten by deer. The food material is stationary, grass is stationary, deer eaten grass. Either the food material is mobile, such as, or here we write instead of deer, grass eaten by cow. Either the food material is mobile, where deer eaten by lion. Either the food material is stationary, and either it is, or it is mobile. Food is taken in and used by the organisms. They can be divided in many strategies depended on the structure of body of the organisms. They can take different ways food in and use them. Here we discuss about organisms, not only green plants, not only animals, not only human, all organisms. So depended on their body design, the food can be taken in different ways. First, in some organisms, break down the complex food materials outside the body and then absorb it. In some organisms, break down the complex food material outside the body and then absorb it. We know the examples. Example of this type of organisms are fungi like bread molds, mushrooms, etc. They can break down complex food material outside the body and then absorb it. Some organisms so take in complex material and break it down inside their bodies. They are outside the body, and these are the example of inside their bodies. Depending on the taken of food, they are divided in three types: herbivores, carnivores, and omnivores. The organisms are take only plants. The animals take only plants, eat only plants. They are called herbivores, We know the example for this: cow, deer, etc. are the example of herbivores. The organisms use animals for their food purpose. We know the example for that: tiger, lion, etc. And omnivores use plants and animals both. The examples of them are cockroach, man, etc. We give two examples for herbivores, carnivores and omnivores. They are enough. As we know and you studied about in chapter number 15, we already write about herbivores, carnivores and omnivores. Here we take the complex material. Some organisms take complex material, break down it inside their bodies, depending on the organisms, take their food purposes. They can be divided into three types: herbivores, carnivores and omnivores. The organisms use only plants, they can animals. Animals use only plants, they called herbivores. Cow and deer are the examples of herbivores. The animals, they have the organism itself, animals, but use animals for their food purpose. They are the examples of tiger and lion, and use plants and animals both. They are omnivores. Cockroach and man are the examples of omnivores. Some organisms derive nutrition from plants or animals without killing them. They are known parasitic nutrition. In lower standard, you already studied about parasitic nutrition. The nutrition from plants or animals without killing them. The examples for parasitic nutrition: tapeworm, cuscuta, we already know is amarbel, and the third one is leech. This one is plant and this one is worm, animal, and this also animal. So parasitic nutrition. So we study brief note on heterotrophic nutrition. First we write about non-chlorophyllous organism. Food material is two types: stationary or mobile. On depending on organism taking food, they can be divided into two types: break down food outside the body, break down the food inside their bodies. Outside their bodies, and then examples: fungi like bread molds, mushrooms, etc. And inside the body, they divided into three types: herbivores, carnivores and omnivores. And the third organisms, this shows organisms first outside the body, the second is inside the body, and third is derive nutrition from plants or animals without killing them. And this is called parasitic nutrition. You already studied about cuscuta in lower standard. This is called amarbel, and tapeworm, which is called so parasitic nutrition, and leech also so parasitic nutrition. So you had to give brief note on heterotrophic nutrition. Let's see heterotrophic nutrition's example. The question is, how do single cell organisms obtain their food nutrition? Here we study about first single cell and then multi-cells organism. The first single cell organism, the organism obtain their nutrition. Example of single cell organisms are amoeba and paramecium. Amoeba and paramecium, so single cell organisms. Here we take example of amoeba. Amoeba shows their nutrition in four ways. As we know, amoeba is in irregular shape, so they show their nutrition in first day. This one is nucleus, this is food particle. This shows pseudopodia. This shows food vacuole. Nutrition in amoeba. Two organisms shows single cell nutrition. Here we take the example of amoeba. In amoeba, temporary finger-like extension can be occur outside the body. They called pseudopodia. As we know, pseudo means folds, and when the irregular shape of amoeba, pseudo finger-like projection can be occur outside the body, and take when the food vacuole is outside, they take food vacuole inside the body. When we say in figure, the food particle is outside the body, and when pseudopodia can develop, they take food particle inside the body. Food vacuole can develop inside the body. Inside food vacuole, complex substances are broken down. This is the heterotrophic nutrition. So complex substances are broken down inside the body, and they can be converted into simpler ones. Diffuse there from cytoplasm. When the food material is diffuse, when food material is broken down, they diffuse from cytoplasm. Remaining undigested material is moved to the surface of the cell and thrown out. Food can be taken by the surface of the cell, and unwanted or remaining undigested material can be thrown on the surface of the cell. So this is called single cell organism. In paramecium, the process is same, but as we know the structure of paramecium, they show definite shape. Food is taken a specific spot, this is called cilia. By the movement of cilia in water, paramecium shows in water. So by the movement of the cilia, the paramecium can take food inside the body. When they can inside the body, the food is covered by the surface of body. When the food is taken inside the body in paramecium, whole process are same. The food vacuole can develop, diffuse the food from cytoplasm, and undigested material is moved to the surface of cell of the paramecium and thrown it. The one thing is differ from for amoeba and paramecium to take food inside the body. In amoeba take food particle by pseudopodia, and paramecium take food particles by cilia. Whole process is same in amoeba and paramecium. The most important question for single cell organisms nutrition source by amoeba, you have to draw the figure for that and give the points. Write the another point for paramecium, and you have to notice about the movement of cilia taking of food, and not need to the write same processes. So the single cell organisms, so their nutrition, the example is amoeba. Let's see the example of human alimentary canal. Human alimentary canal is extending just like a tube like structure, extending from mouth to anus. Human alimentary canal is a tube-like structure extending. Here we write about extending from mouth to anus. See the diagram of human alimentary canal. First we draw the mouth. In mouth, the tongue is present. This is the esophagus. This tube-like structure is esophagus. Food is taken by mouth and go through esophagus, then go inside the stomach. In stomach, they can remain in 4 to 5 hours, and then the food is go inside the large small intestine, and unwanted or undigested food is outside through the large intestine by anus. First we draw the mouth. In mouth we draw tongue, and then draw the esophagus, stomach. This part shows liver. In stomach, behind the stomach, small gland can be present, which is called, this one is called pancreas. And bile secreted by bile ducts through liver. And this is so the diaphragm. We saw the function of diaphragm detail in respiration. First, we saw the part of intestine. This large part shows large intestine, and Inside large intestine, small finger-like structures are present, which is called small intestine. Behind the large intestine, the last part is anus, and this one is shows appendix. So the diagram shows alimentary canal or digestive system. Digestive system of human. You have to ask question in exam. Draw the neat and labored diagram of alimentary canal and other is or digestive system. You have to diagram and label. Labels are mouth, tongue, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, anus, appendix. Behind stomach, one gland is present. It is called pancreas, bile duct, liver, and diaphragm are the label for alimentary canal. In sometimes students draw the small intestine like this. These are not the finger like projection, so you have to draw with the carefully. Finger like projections are called small intestine. There are many finger like projection can be present to absorb the food in small intestine. So I can repeat the question. Draw the human alimentary canal with label diagram, or draw the neat and label diagram of digestive system of human. Both are same, the words are same, diagram are same. You have to carefully draw with the label.